after all these years, in theory, finally about to get the upgrade she so desperately needs. Well, if you listen to the chatter and noise out there, it is coming very, very soon here with a major announcement at Apple WWDC. Stay tuned to the video. What's up, people? This your boy Viper, the man about tech, back again for the video. And yes, in about 48 hours, Apple will go out there and announce brand new iOS, iPadOS, watchOS features at their annual Worldwide Developer Conference. But all the rumor and conjecture leading up to this year's event have been rumored overhaul, not only of the operating system, but of Apple's much maligned virtual assistant Siri. So if you listen to the reporting out there from Mark Gurman of Bloomberg and the 9to5 Mac and the Mac rumors out there, Apple is about to actually form a partnership with OpenAI. And if OpenAI sound familiar to you, they should, because they are the ones who made the famous ChatGPT. So what does this mean for Apple? Well, this means that according to the rumors out there, Apple is going to come out this week at WWDC and announce Apple Intelligence. I know. Before y'all run to me or whatever, listen, man, y'all know how Apple is with marketing. They're going to go out here on this WWDC stage and they're going to act like nobody else has done AI before Apple has done it. It's going to be wild. It's going to be crazy. But we in the tech space, we know better. We know better. But I digress. So what does that mean for Siri? That means that Siri is going to get a more conversational tone and feel to her. So instead of talking to a robot, you'll feel like you're actually talking to an actual person with these upgrades rumored to come here with the unveiling of Apple Intelligence. Also, there's thought that Siri will have control over individual features in app. So let's say something like respond to an email, maybe take a photo. Distinct individual functions within app, Siri will be able to control those by your command. So those are just a couple of things that will help with the upgraded Siri. But when it comes to Apple Intelligence, it's about more than Siri. They're going to add a boatload of AI features across all of their operating systems. So let's talk a little bit more about what's coming.
Future Editing Viper here. What I failed to mention in the video is that if you want access to these AI features that are coming with these latest OS updates, you will need an iPhone 15 Pro or newer. iPhone 14s and older will not work with these new AI features. Even the regular iPhone 15 series like the iPhone 15 and 15 Plus, those phones will not have access to these AI features. You will need an iPhone 15 Pro or Pro Max or a newer iPhone coming later this year to have access to the AI stuff. As far as iPads are concerned, you will need an iPad that has the M1 chip or newer, so M1, M2, and the new M4. Any iPad that have older chips will not have access to these AI features. Also, while you're here, hit that subscribe button for more of this Apple content.
So as it relates to Safari, Safari is rumored to get intelligent search that uses AI to identify key topics and phrases to provide a summary. This kind of feels to me like what we already have on Google right now. If you go pull out your phone or you go to your desktop or laptop and you type in a search query into the Google search bar, you get that little AI blurb of a summary of what you were searching for, and then you get the actual search result below that. So it looks like Safari is going to get something like that. So that'd be pretty cool. Although the big problem with AI sometimes is that it hallucinates or lies. It makes up stuff that's not actually true. So hopefully whatever Apple is working on, it will be smarter than the AI that is out there right now. But we'll have to see how that looks here when they unveil it in a few days here. Also, the mail app is going to get the ability to suggest smart replies. Again, this is something that's already present in Google and Gmail, but now you'll have it in the Apple Mail app. I don't know how many of you all use that app. I avoid it like the plague, but hey, if you are an Apple Mail app user, then you got smart replies coming. This could be helpful. It can cut down on your email writing time, reply time, different things like that. So that's cool. Photos is going to get an upgrade as well with Apple Intelligence. You're going to get the ability to remove unwanted objects from images. Again, we already have stuff like this. I feel like I'm not like a broken record, but we already have this on Samsung and Google phones with object eraser and different things like that. But now these things are going to officially come to Apple. And even though I keep saying that all these things exist on Google and other services already, you have to remember that when Apple normally dips their toe into another feature set or new features, they usually do it better than everybody's done it before them. So I keep saying that we already have this on Google and Android and whatnot, but that doesn't mean that Apple will do it the same as they're doing it on Google and Android. Apple, for whatever reason, they always find a way to add a little more thought to it, to make it a little bit better than it's already being done. The other cool thing about what Apple is unveiling with their AI this week is that they're going to work to have a lot of this stuff done on device, which means your device won't have to communicate with the cloud in order to enable some of these AI features and functionality. Now, some stuff will have to go out to the cloud, but it is rumored that Apple's working on doing a lot of this stuff on device, which means it should happen a lot quicker. For anybody like myself that has a Google Android with AI capability, if you want to do something like edit a feature with AI or edit a picture, excuse me, first the phone have to communicate with the cloud, and then the cloud would do all the editing, and then it'll come back down on the phone. And that takes like 5, 10, 15 seconds sometimes. It takes a while. So the fact that Apple is going to have the ability to do some of that stuff on device, if they can, means that what will take you 15, 20, 30 seconds on an Android might take you just a second or two on the iPhone, assuming that they can bring some of that stuff to happen on device. Speaking of other Apple apps to gain AI capability, Apple Music is going to get a feature that will use AI to auto-generate playlists. Now, I guess this will be based on your listening history and how you listen to music and the type of songs and the artists and the genre. I guess AI will use all that to auto-generate a playlist for you, so that's pretty cool. I kind of like curating my own music, but I mean, hey, if a machine can do it for you and do it to a great degree, then I guess that can't really be a bad thing. So we'll have to see how that plays out again when we get our hands on that with these beta OS and coming out next week. Now, it seems like Apple's major focus with this WWDC will be AI. I don't know how many like new features will be coming to the OSs. I think Apple is more focused about making sure their AI features are available across iOS, iPadOS, watchOS, macOS, tvOS. So it seems like with this WWDC, the focus is going to be making sure that these AI rollout go smoothly across all of their ecosystem instead of bringing new features. Not to say that your OS are not going to get new features, because they will, but I think the bigger focus for Apple is going to be their rollout of Apple Intelligence and making it work smoothly across all your Apple devices. But in my last video, I did talk about what will be coming via WWDC for my Vision Pro owners. So if you have a Vision Pro and you want to know what might be coming down the pipe, check out that video right there.